Hey folks, this is Sebastian. We have not released a new video in a while because we're working on a big update for FIFOX, and yes, it's finally here. If you have not heard about our app before, it's called FIFOX. It uses the sensors in your phone for physics experiments. It's free, it's now open source, and it's amazing. So just check out our website fifox.org or this YouTube channel to learn what you can do with this app. In this video, I will introduce the new features. So if you are already familiar with the app, you will learn something new, but first, a new logo. Okay, let's start with the most requested feature, which many of you will find useful, interactive graphs. With this new feature, you can tap any graph and it will cover the whole screen. Here you can now pan and zoom the graph with the typical gestures that you know from other apps. If you leave the interactive mode by tapping somewhere outside the graph, you will get a dialog asking you whether you want to keep the zoom level or if you want to reset it. Here you also get advanced options where you can, for example, pick that a single axis should only be reset or where you can synchronize your axis with other graphs. So for example, we can choose to reset the y-axis and make the x-axis follow new data and also set the same setting for all the other x-axis of the other graphs. So FIFOX will effectively scroll to the right in all the graphs with the new data. Also in the interactive mode, you can choose the pick tool. With this, you can read off individual data points by simply tapping them, or you can drag between two data points to read the difference of both points and the slope between them. In the tools menu, you will also find a fit function to make a linear fit to your data and a function to export only the data set of the current graph. This might allow you to export the data to different apps, which otherwise would not be able to cope with the entire data set provided by FIFOX. Besides the interactive mode, we also have some new graph types. So for example, we've got bar charts, which are used here for the acoustic stopwatch in an infinite mode, where you can measure as many time intervals as you like. So effectively, I can currently measure the BPM I'm doing while snapping with my fingers. Also, we now have a color plot, which is used with the audio spectrum here, so you get a history of the audio spectrum. When using the remote access to view the data through the web browser, not all of these features are available, but some improvements have been made here as well, like having a full view for a single graph or seeing the color plot. The other big feature is a Bluetooth interface to receive data from external sensors or to send data from FIFOX to external devices. This feature is quite complex, so we will create another video with all the details. Here I will just give you a quick overview. In the easiest version, you can scan for Bluetooth devices from the main screen. If you have something that is known to FIFOX, it will give you a few options to record data from this device. So, for example, here we use a Texas Instruments sensor tag to measure the relation of temperature and pressure. We will try to support as many devices as we can, of course, with the help and consent of the manufacturers. In principle, you can use different devices in your own experiment configurations, so you can use our web editor to read from any device, to analyze the data and to plot it in whichever form you would like. And for the advanced users, this of course means that you can use your own projects with FIFOX as long as they have a Bluetooth Low Energy interface. Plot the data from your Arduino project or control your BBC Microbit with sensor data from FIFOX. You can find examples and documentation on this on our website fifox.org, and as mentioned before, we will release a separate video for this. Now, to support so many different Bluetooth devices, we need to be able to create a configuration for each device and then transfer it to our phone. And here we also have made many improvements. The experiment configurations in FIFOX have always been defined in our own file format, and you have always been able to create your own configurations with the web editor on our website. This has now been improved, as it of course supports all the new features and allows you to create Bluetooth experiments as well. On top of that, you can now freely arrange the modules in your experiment, and it is now much easier to transfer your creation to your phone and share it with students. This is now done through QR codes, which you can simply scan from the main screen in FIFOX. These QR codes are generated by the editor, and it also allows you to combine an entire set of configurations to share everything you need in a class at once.
By the way, the QR code you just saw actually contains a link to the internet where FreeFox can download the experiment configuration. Unfortunately, this is not available at every school, so if you need an offline version, you have the option to create an offline QR code which contains the entire experiment. These tend to become a little bit bulky and you need to save some space, so you cannot include an experiment icon or some translations maybe, but they work just fine.
There are many more improvements, bug fixes and other new features, like the new applause meter, colored categories and multiplot versions of the raw data experiments. You can find the whole changelog on our website.
So I hope you liked the big update. If you want to learn more about FreeFox or our new Bluetooth interface, visit freefox.org. And don't worry, we are planning on releasing more videos. So until then, see you in the next video.